I'm calling to report a murder. I'm the night manager at Aurelia's Fantasy Suites over on West Alexander Street. Please hurry.
Sir, is the victim a hotel guest?
I don't know exactly. She's in there in the Cupid Suite. Jeez, there's just a lot of blood. Look, I really need the cops to get here as soon as possible. I'll wait for them in the parking lot, okay? This is really freaking me out.
Sir, if you could please stay on the line with me a while.
Hey, Kat. I'm calling because... Well, because you and I both know what happened last night was no accident, right? So I just want you to know, you better keep your promise, all right? That way, I keep mine, and we're cool, okay? Okay, that's it.
What do you think? It sounds like a threat, but I just have a hard time imagining Charlie really intimidating Kathy. I would think, if anything, it would be the other way around, but I suppose anything's possible. Let's see what Brass thinks.
Hey.
Show me what you got. Well, appearances might be deceiving, but that sounds like Charlie Steer has something to confess. I'll see what I can do.
Mr. Steer, we heard the message you left on Kathy Bird's cell phone.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. She played it for you, didn't she? Damn it!
Well, if it's any consolation, our threat seemed a little more convincing than yours.
What did she tell you?
Something about how badly you needed a purse, and how you stabbed Lynn Bowder in the throat to get one.
What?!
You don't look like much, Charlie, so I get it. After you left the voicemail, you wanted to make absolutely sure Kathy understood you weren't playing games, so you paid her a little visit. You know, it's just bad luck that we were there at the apartment when you did.
No! Look, you got it all wrong, man! I didn't kill that girl! Kat killed her!
It's your classic he said, she said.
Yeah, but Kat called me to the room, man! That's how it went down! And that blonde chick, I mean, she was already lying there on the bed! She was dead when I walked in there, man! You gotta believe me!
My what?
You know, your limos, your kicks. Isn't that what the kids are calling them these days? Hand them over, Charlie.
Oh, you gotta be... Okay, fine.
Charlie was pretty twitchy. I wonder if he dropped some of his stash. I think you just found the missing piece to this puzzle. Nice work. We should be able to get that print now. There you go. Good as new. Gotta love it when you pull a fingerprint off the murder weapon. Now, let's hope we get a match. We found traces of identical carpet cleaner on both the floor of the crime scene and on Charlie Steer's shoe. I thought he said cleaning was the maid's job. Print proves Kathy Bird handled the murder weapon. We got her. Manipulating evidence isn't usually what you want to do if you're innocent.
What are you talking about? I didn't clean up the crime scene.
I'd say you cleaned up to make yourself look less guilty.
No, no way. That's not how it happened. I did help clean up, but Kat killed that blonde!
So instead of calling the cops, you helped her cover up a murder? Why should we believe that?
Because I love her, man, okay? It's crazy, I know. Kat comes to the hotel all the time with all kinds of dudes, and we have this kind of, arrangement. I give her the room off the books, and she kicks me back some cash from her dates. Sometimes she even gives me, like I said, we have an arrangement, man.
So that's why Dominguez didn't have to register?
Yeah, I'll admit it. I confess, I stole from the hotel. Great, but I swear on my grandmother's grave, I did not kill that chick. I'll take a lie detector. I'll do whatever it takes. You know what I'm saying?
If you love Kathy enough to cover up a murder for her, why threaten her?
It's pathetic, right? I'm in love with her, and she just laughs at me, man. But what can I do? Last night, she calls me, right? And she says she needs me. I go in the room, and oh my God, all that blood! And Kat's standing there, right? And she's just a mess, completely helpless. And I get to be her Superman. I mean, who wouldn't want that job, right? I could save her. I say I'll clean up. I'll clean it all up. I'll pretend I never saw her, and I'll make it kind of look like the Mexican did it, you know? So she says, what would I do without you? You see, the deal was, we'd cover for each other, okay? But I always knew. I knew she wouldn't keep her word. In the back of my mind, I knew. You know what I'm saying? That's why I called her. That's why I showed up at her place. I knew. I knew she'd never keep her word. I was just hoping. Oh, I don't know what I was thinking. Yeah, I took it, and I tried to use it. Damn. I needed to get high to try to forget the whole thing, you know? I don't know. I know that this Lynn chick, I guess when she came to town, I didn't see Kat for a while. Then, like, out of nowhere, man, I see Kat with this chick and this Mexican dude at the hotel, and it's like the normal routine. And she says, hey, Charlie, give him the special. I just wanted to talk to her. Jeez. But she blows me off, then you guys show up. I step right in the mud.
I'll bring her in.